Zohar, Yom Shemini, Yom Shishi, le parashat Yitro. Le Pekuda, le Mehede d'Achir Yom HaShabbat. It's a mitzvah to remember Shabbat. Kemada Tamer, as it is written, Zachor et Yom HaShabbat le Kadesho. Remember Yom Shabbat to sanctify it. Raza de Shabbat, Haokmoa Bechol Inun Durte, Yoma de Nae Cha de Alma, Yehu Klala de Oreta. The secret of Shabbat, we have explained it in a lot of different places. It's a day of rest for the whole world. Yehuklala Torah, and also encompasses all the Torah. Uman de Natir Shabbat, Kilu Natir Oreta Kula. And the one that is Shomer Shabbat, who means he keeps Shabbat, it's like he keeps the whole Torah. Why is this said? Because the Shabbat is it confirms two things. First, it confirms about the creation, because in the creation it says it's first day, second day, third day, etc. And then when it comes to the seventh day, it says Yom HaShabbat, that like we say in the Kiddush, Vayichal b'Yom HaShabbat. Vayishbot b'yom haShabbat, right? E vayikadesh v'barech b'yom haShavei. Okay, so it's every time we say Yom HaShavei, we're talking about Shabbat. So we admit that the creation was done by Hashem, that it was done in 6 days, and the seventh day vayichal b'yom haShavei, he stopped on the seventh day. Vayishbot, he rested on Yom HaShavei, which is Shabbat, right? And v'barech, and he did a beracha. Which is Shabbat. So we confirm these three things. This is one. The second, in the tenth commandment, we know that the three first commandments are about Hashem, right? And the fourth one, that the first one that is directly to man, is to respect Shabbat, right? So when we respect Shabbat, then we confirm these two things. We confirm the creation, and we confirm also the receiving of the Ten Commandments. And we have learned also to remember Shabbat and to sanctify it with all the different ways of sanctifying the Shabbat. He's like the one that remembers the king. And we're talking about Hashem, someone that says Hashem, he has to bless, right? You want to eat something. Right, so you bless Hashem, well, in a way, okay, but you remember that you have to do that. He did the same thing about Shabbat. What is written? Liskor et Yom HaShabbat. So you have to remember it. The same thing as soon as Shabbat comes, okay, you have to sanctify it. Ve'aitamar, and we have learned Zachor lidachura ihu shamor ihu linukva. And we know that in the first time we receive the Ten Commandments is written Zachor et Yom HaShabbat. And on the second time that we receive the Ten Commandments, there is a change. It's called Shamor et Yom HaShabbat. So when it says Zachor, which means remember, we're talking about the masculine. And the masculine is what? Is the Melech, right? And when we say Shamor, which is keep the Shabbat, we're talking about the Nekeva, right? The feminine. And this is, there's no separation between whether it's Zachor, whether it's Shamor, whether it's feminine, whether it's masculine, it's the same. It's just two different facets of the same thing. Yom Shabbat, Chaza Dechol, Meimunata, Detalia, Meresha, Ila'a, Asufa, Dechol Dargin. Yom Shabbat is the secret of all the Emunah, of all the faith. Shetailu Mirosh Ha'elion, Asuf, Kola Madrigot, that come from all the way up. And then that covers everything. I mean, all, and we're talking about the Merkava, we're talking about the Sefirot, everything, until we get to Malchut, and Malchut represents Shabbat. Idi Shabbat, Yuhukola, Shabbat, Huakol, Shabbat is everything. So what does that mean? Because what happens in Shabbat is that everything is elevated. First of all, time is elevated, which is a time that is not a regular time. It's a time where we have to act differently. And we act differently, and at the same time, we come in, if we want, in this dimension, which is called Shabbat. Which means you have to separate yourself from everything that is work, everything that is creation, everything that is part of the regular week. And then when you separate yourself from that, then you get in into this dimension, which is called Shabbat. Now, at the same time that you come in spiritually into Shabbat, you also have to do some physical acts for Shabbat, right? Like you do a nice seuda, a nice meal, go to the synagogue, be in a good mood, dress in a special clothes of Shabbat. So also, physically, you separate yourself from everything that you do during the week. So you elevate this the material into the spiritual. And then the spiritual, you bring even higher to a level which is not the regular level. And this is the level of Shabbat. That's why it's called Zachor V'Shamor. So Zachor, we can understand it like remember the Shabbat, but we can also remember Zachor, remember what happened before, right? In the creation, and remember when we got the Ten Commandments, Zachor, don't forget, see? And Shamor, which means to keep the Shabbat, but also Shamor is to keep yourself, right? To keep yourself from everything that is exterior to this Ruchaniyut, to this spirituality, which is Shabbat. Because in reality, Shabbat is a pleasure. V'kore, Shabbat, Onek, right? You will call a Shabbat a Onek, something that is pleasurable. Because it's a time, what is the time for you, for your family, for your spirituality to come out and to flourish, if we want, and to expand. And this is the whole idea of doing Shabbat. Amen.